Good day, fish tankers. I've kept many fish in the past, among them these Oscars, that I would love to keep again. So too the fancy goldfish that you see here. I just like their bumbling way of swimming about the tank. And then I've also had discus in the past, and I even had them breeding, but I must admit I couldn't raise a fry. And I would like to take a stab at discus again. And at one stage I had a 5-foot tank with lots of larger rainbow fish like the Busmanis. That's something also that I would like to revisit, and not forgetting the good old platy. But this is not a video about fish that I've kept in the past. This is a video of a bucket list of 7 fish that I have never kept before and I would like to take a stab at. If that sounds interesting, stick around. Well, coming in here at number 1 is the Starry Night Cichlid, or Paratilapia pollini. If I ever get space for another big tank, then maybe I should forego the Oscars and try and take a stab at these big cichlids. They look like they have plenty of personality. The only time I've seen them are these here in the shop. Please leave a comment if you've kept them before. I would like to know what your experience was. But they seem like those kind of personality fish, and they are certainly striking, and that seems like a good candidate for a big species tank, and they do look like something else. Then coming in at number 2 is this little fellow, the peacock gudgeon. They're very colourful. They have that nuchal hump in the males, as you can see there, and they seem to stake out a spot in the tank much like cichlids do, even though they are gudgeons. And even the female has got good colour. And that's a fish that doesn't need to have a massive tank. So it's something that I definitely want to try my hand at. Guys, please, as always, remember to smash that like button. And here's a more realistic one, because it's almost a nano fish. It only needs a small tank. And this is the Ruby Tetra. That is something that will look good in a planted tank. It's a tetra that's sort of relatively new here in the South African scene. They'll go good in your 5-gallon to 10-gallon tank. A small show of them, and as you can see, they're also shrimp safe if you see those shrimp scuttling about there in the Soeswater tank. And that's a fish that I think might be interesting for the future. Then coming up at number 4 is the Asian Rummy Nose. Now these guys look sort of drab in the dealer's tank, but they get a very nice metallic blue and a red nose, especially the males. There you can see in the insert what they become like if they have a nice planted tank. And that's something that I have only seen. This is about the second time when I recorded this in South Africa. And there's definitely a tetra that I would be into. Now, these are the Demosoni or the Demosoni cichlids coming up at number 5. And that's not what I want to keep, because I've kept them before and they're aggressive as heck. I want to keep something similar. And that is, of course, a Chindongo Salosi. It's something I saw on George Farmer's channel. And they've got striking sexual dimorphism. The male is a blue banded one and the female is the yellow one. So I would like to keep these in the species tank, maybe with a few Cynodontis catfish added instead of a Demosoni, because they are not as aggro. So they look interesting to me. And these you recognize, but I've never kept them before, and that is the Platinum Halfbeak. Now, these guys are live bearers. I would like to see if I can get some youngsters, and they're interesting, sitting there like a little crocodilian almost. Quite an interesting, different fish. Guys, please remember to share. And the next fish coming in here at number 7 is something that most of you have kept, but I've never kept them, and that's the Hillstream Loach. Here we see a reticulated Hillstream Loach. Definitely a nice, interesting little fish. As you can see, especially when they're against the glass, they look like little stingrays. And guys, that is it for me today. As always, please remember to hit that subscribe button. I greatly appreciate that. And until I see you again, take good care of those domestic denizens of the deep.